watching the vlog. I guess I'm back. I guess there's a whole bunch of things I haven't done in quite some time. I haven't been doing anything for the past, I guess, a month or so. But you know what? It's time to change that. I'm back, and it feels good. So what's been going on for the past couple weeks? I haven't been doing anything. Well, first off, I'm still working, I guess. That's kind of a positive thing. I am still with my girlfriend. That's pretty good, too. Went to UConn. Let's go into that first. UConn, yeah, it's still a very small con, but, you know, I think it's going to get better with every year because it's starting to expand a little bit. There's still some things problems with it, but overall it was a good time. Like both years that they've done this, they've had Doug and Rob Walker, you know, of That Guy with Glasses.com, you know, doing everything that, you know, being the main guest, and that's, you know, they do some really good stuff with the, you know, when they go to cons, and this was no exception. I mean, Zod is officially running for president. Those of you who know what I'm talking about know that's like possibly one of the biggest deals of all time. I mean, the amount of cosplay that was there, it was mediocre to really good. So it's one of those hit or miss things. I'm not going to like make fun of anybody's cosplay or anything, because even with, like, you know, the worst cosplayers, they're still doing something. They're still attempting, you know, what they're trying to do. So, more power to people who can actually, you know, get something done. Like me, I just go for anything that I can find. Like, really can't wait for my next con, because that's when I'll be debuting the Temp Doctor. And unfortunately, the beard is going to go for it. And I'll be back to clean shaven, and it'll be me virtually, like, Catholic schoolboy me. So, with the gelled hair as I had it, and also the sideburns. That was me back in high school. Yeah, not too impressed with that. No. Now that I think of it. But yeah, UConn. Some plus things about it. Yeah, they brought back Robin Doug Walker, so that's really cool to see him again. I got a picture with both of them this time, and Doug made a comment about me dressed up as him. And then Rob appreciate, you know, my name, because we share the same name, so that's pretty cool, too. The, you know, just overall, this is just the overall experience that I really do enjoy at this one, because it's up at UConn. UConn is kind of a drive from me, because I'm down in Southern Connecticut, it's up in upstate Connecticut, and it's just a really fun time, you know, going up there. Like, I never got to go up to UConn, like, at all during, like, my college years, because I didn't know too many people actually went up there. Those who I didn't know who were up there, I was on very good terms as they were, you know. Well, not bad terms or anything, it's just I wasn't close to them, so I didn't, like, have any purpose to go up and visit them. And just the overall atmosphere I liked a lot, so that was pretty cool. And some other things, like, you know, just a few cons I had with it. With this one, I mean, the line for autographs, you know, with the walkers was just, I thought it was, like, a bit atrocious, because there were people place-holding for other people, and if you really want to just make things a little easier, just go to the back of the line. Come on, folks. And instead, here's people, oh, the line's moving, but you're not moving at all. So, con staff, just you know, maybe regulate the lines a bit. If, like, so if you see someone trying to, you know, place hold for other people, just send them to the back of the line. Come on, just be courteous to other people. The line was long enough, and people were taking a long time with, you know, the guests, but that's why I didn't ask Doug to do anything for me this time. I was going to ask him to do a 3-word movie review, maybe even a new intro for the vlogs, but whatever. What else is there? Oh, yeah. Old Man Noises is still rocking out of the house. Just saw him at the Huntington Street Cafe, which is, it's like a little, like, you know, coffee shop type setting that I go to for, you know, lunch and dinner and stuff. It has some pretty good stuff to eat there. That's very good. Went there, you know, saw some old friends, so that was really cool to see them. Anyway, it was just a good time. I mean, I just like how they actually use the, like everybody used their space great. Like, you know, just like Mike, like, you know, rhythm guitar, he was using, like, the chairs that were out there. Doug was using chairs. Rich was using, everybody was using, like, everything. And unfortunately, with a lot of the shots I was trying to get, I could not get too many good shots of Anthony, who was on drums, so. Every time he would move, his cymbal would be in the way of his face, so that's kind of the deal that it's really hard to, like, just take photos from where I was trying not to block anybody and try to do something good for them. I don't have enough footage to actually make another vlog, but, well, you know, for him right now, but, you know, like, you know, future shows, I will, though. Because they're good friends of mine, so I want to, like, you know, help them out as much as I can. It's the same thing with all of my friends who are big fans of actually done stuff for, so I just really want to help them out as much as I can. I got a couple cons I'm going to, like, you know, hopefully. This is a big hopefully, because mainly because work is kind of weird about that, because I just try to, you know, I put all my time, like, you know, time off, you know, at the beginning of the year, and I really want to, you know, get some time so I can go to these cons with friends, you know, hang out with them, because it's, you know, it's mainly with, like, a bunch of my college friends. And I never really get to see them too much anymore because, you know, they're busy with school, I'm busy with work, and I can't get up to college, you know, every so often, as much as I want to, because I have to get up the next morning for work, and it kind of sucks, but what are you going to do about that? I mean, hopefully with these cons, you know, I'll be trying to get to Anime Boston. I've never gone to this one. I really want to get to this one. There's a whole bunch of, like, other, like, you know, con friends that are going to be there, so that's going to be pretty cool. Gonna return to Anime Next. That's gonna be really awesome again. Hopefully it's not gonna bug me too much, because last year a friend of mine told me that it was pretty much overrun by kids, and when you see kids at cons, there's one of two things that happen. Number one, you got the really annoying ones who was like, oh, I'm at a con, so I'm gonna do whatever the hell I want. My parents aren't here, da da da, all that other crap that happens like that. And number two, there's going to be a buttload of people with free hug signs. I have nothing wrong with free hug signs. It's just that most of the time when you see these kids, they're kind of desperate. That's why I think many cons kind of, you know, get rid of them. You know, like, say you can't have, like, you know, signs or anything like that, or signs that say free hugs, because they kind of say it's prostitution or something like that. I don't know. If I'm just sitting around doing nothing and just hanging out with some people, then I'll go give them hugs. I'm not, like, seek out everybody who has a free hug sign just to get a hug. I mean, come on. Whatever. So yeah, that's going to be my story. More things on the horizon. It's going to be a good time.